pretty early in the morning. We are back at Optimum with our coach Nia, and just getting in our training, man. It's so important that we keep our bodies in shape while we're in the middle of this whole rehearsal process. That's what Nia's here for. He's making sure that we're gonna peak at the right time, that we have all the stamina, all the endurance, all the strength that we need for the show. And this is the part that a lot of people don't see, man. They think that it's just show up to class, or you watch a dance video on YouTube, or we just get in the studio and choreograph. But no, it's like it's around the clock. It's we're athletes, you know. Dance is not just our passion and not just our art form, but it's also our sport. So we're about to run act one for the very, very first time. Super nervous. It's about 45 minutes in length. A little tired earlier from training, but just excited to try it for the first time with everyone.
That was our first run through, which is actually pretty amazing how polished it looked, considering that's the first time the dancers had done everything. Man, I am so excited for people to see this. Like, we still have a long ways to go, lighting, sounds, costume sets, but it's really gonna come together, and this is gonna be something special.
So today we've had a full day of fittings with our entire cast. I got a lot of good feedback from our dancers in a sense of, can we get more movement out of this costume, or this is too tight, I'm gonna split my pants, which is always a concern. But we've gotten a really good start with what their costume is gonna start looking like and shaping their character. I wanted to really have a strong sense of individuality between each character and dancer in the show. I think that's a good part of what Beyond Babel is trying to convey. Like, everybody's their own human, their own person, their own character. So each person kind of has their own color scheme to work with. And then as the story progresses, their color scheme kind of changes depending on where we are in the story. No one is truly uniform in here, even though we have a character that wears a uniform. Even that is a little bit more individualized towards his character and his progression in the story.
So in this dance show, we're creating this world, and the wall is such a big part of the storyline. So the crochet elements are able to define different sides of the wall. And I use different techniques, one very Mari and feminine and beautiful, and then Keone is much more vibrant and bright. And using those themes, I was able to create very different pieces for both of them, but hopefully they weave together nicely. It was really exciting getting to work on this dance show because I grew up dancing. Every day after school, I would go to the dance studio. I'd be in Nutcracker rehearsals every year. So I know what it takes to put on a dance show and what it's like to be a dancer in a show. So each piece that I created, I was thinking about the movement and how the dancers could interact with it. So things had to be simple, but also beautiful and workable at the same time.